There are four attackers in insurance. The first, of course, the insurtechs. What do we see right now? We see the mega rounds. We see the hundreds of millions poured in one company. It's Ladder, it's Lemonade, WeFox, Hippo, and those companies. And we see also new companies popping up. So we see second waves and third waves of insurtech, like Lovebox or Bold Penguin in the US. And the big threat I personally think insurtech faces is not so much that there's suddenly 10, 20, 30% of our business gone. I think with the biggest threat, for example, of Lemonade entering the insurance market is not they getting a lot of market share, but that especially Asian and Chinese large insurance companies see how easy it is to enter the European market. And when they're coming, their pockets are way deeper than ours. The second attacker here are these tech companies, Google, Facebook, Alibaba. Why are they so dangerous? They're dangerous out of two reasons. First, they're dangerous because they know how to disrupt. So when Jeff Bezos sits down and says, I'm going for this industry, then they have a master plan, they go into it, and they're going into it ruthless. Amazon did not let alive any single serious online book dealer. And I'm sure when they go into other industries, they won't do it neither. And they're very good at disrupting themselves. When engineers came to Jeff Bezos and showed him the Kindle, and the business guy said, we cannot do this, this will destroy our book revenue. Jeff said, well, better we destroy our book revenue than others do it. So, and I know the insurance industry is known for a lot of things, but we are not very known at disrupting others or even ourselves. And another threat the tech giants have is they pour a lot of money into research and development. Amazon spends $22 billion in research and development, and Google 15% of its revenue, which is $16 billion US dollar in research and development. This would be just to say, to have an example, Allianz making $130 billion, they would need to spend almost $20 billion US dollar in research and development of technology. And I think this is a numbers that really, really, really should make us understand how dangerous these tech giants are. Then a big attacker are also incumbents. What I see in the last 2 years are especially mid-sized and smaller players who, out of some reason, suddenly really do a lot of innovation, think about new business models, have a lot of projects under the radar going on, and suddenly a lot of positive examples pop up, and they are growing over market average. So I think that incumbents are also one of the four attackers of the insurance industry. And last but not least, the reinsurer. I always say the reinsurers are a little bit like the Darth Vaders of the insurance industry. Of course, they have problem of lowering margins due to certain market conditions, but if you are officially or even behind the scenes working on ecosystems, on technology that in tendency could also replace parts of the direct insurer. So that are the four attackers, and I think that's the reason why we need to be so super speedy, and because others are entering our space.